Have you ever needed to film something at night, but realized you absolutely didn't have the gear, money, or time to do so, and figured you would just wing it during the day and then fix it in post? Because I sure have, and here's how I did it. Okay, so obviously the first thing you're gonna need is some footage shot during the day, and ideally you'd want to shoot during an overcast, cloudy day. You want clouds, you don't want any kind of bright blue skies with sunshine that would cast harsh shadows on the ground, because that's just not realistic for a night shot. So here I have some very basic footage that I shot for my latest video in park, and let's head over to our color tab to see what we can do with it. So the first node we're gonna work with will be used to basically darken the shit out of everything. So let's just name it dark for now, and let's head over to our color wheels and just push everything towards the blue, our shadows, our midtones, our highlights. And I wanna give it some cold vibe. Actually, I want it to be hella cold. And then you can start darkening everything with the offset wheel if you'd like, but the most efficient work will be with the curves here, and you just want to drag your highlights low. Like, really low. You can play around with them and put them however you please. I just want to keep some blue here. Yeah, that looks about right. And maybe I'm going to darken my highlights a bit more, just so it's not too bright in the sky. Also, please note that I'm just doing a very fast tutorial here to give you a general idea of how this works, but for your final project you might want to separate your skies or your brightest areas with a power window in order to darken it separately, just to give it a better look. So my night look is basically done, but I just want to give it more life, and to do that I'm going to turn on the light in this lamppost here. So let's add a parallel node and work with that the night for now. And to do that, you're gonna need to separate your lamp area from the rest of the image. So let's draw a power curve window around it. You would obviously need to make it way better for a real project, but again, this is just to give you an idea. And now let's head over to our color wheels again and just work on the highlights, and you're gonna drag that towards the color you want your lamp to look like. So I'm just gonna stick to some kind of yellow orangish. And then with the wheel, you're gonna increase or decrease the intensity of the light, however it fits your project. This looks good for me. So let's see what we have now. That actually looks pretty good, nice. And then, since the light is on, we're gonna need to brighten up the area under it, because it makes sense, you know, so let's add another parallel node. And let's, oh, forgot to name the first one, so that was our lamp. And this is gonna be the lit area, basically. And we're gonna have to draw another window, so let's grab our curve again. And you want to give it some kind of a triangle shape. Ish, but the actual shape doesn't really matter that much. The most important part is the softness of it. You want to increase the outside softness as much as possible, because you want the light to spread evenly and softly around the whole area, because that just looks more natural than a beam of light. And then let's get our color wheels again, and in the highlights, let's just drag that towards the same color that you gave your lamp before, because consistency. And let's just play around with the intensity again. It has to fit whatever you like. It has to look kind of realistic and consistent. Just play around with the shape, play around with the softness of it until you like the results. So let's see what we have now, and it looks pretty good. And then you can use the same tricks to turn on the lights in the windows of a house, or the headlights of a car, or whatever else fits your shot, basically, until the final result sparks joy. That being said, I'll leave you with the final footage before and after color correction and sound design, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching!